Hi everyone, welcome to this week's episode of Forbes Flash. Thanks for joining us. Do you know who the wealthiest resident in your state is? This week, we released our fifth annual richest person in each state list, so now you can find out. Thanks to a few ties, there are 53 billionaires and centi-millionaires on the list, with a collective net worth of $875 billion. For those of you following this year after year, you'll know that total is a new record. Not surprisingly, a quarter of that total wealth comes from four billionaires in big tech. Some states are home to multiple high-profile billionaires, like Washington, where Jeff Bezos and Bill Gates live. In states like Alabama, Alaska, Delaware, New Hampshire, New Mexico, and Vermont, you only need a nine-figure net worth to take the top spot. Notably, North Dakota now has its first billionaire, hotelier Gary Tharaldson. He's been the state's richest person since 2015, but this is his first year in the 3, Club. Continuing on with our coverage of the world's richest people, last week was a good one for French businessman Bernard Arnault. He joined the world's most exclusive club, that of Centi-Billionaires. There are only two other members, Amazon's Jeff Bezos and Microsoft co-founder Bill Gates. Arnault, as the chairman and CEO of LVMH, has managed to keep the luxury brand fresh, even after 35 years in luxury goods. How? By appealing to new generations of customers while maintaining the values of the brands. In 1984, he put up $15 million of his family's money to rescue bankrupt textile empire Boussac, which included the assets of Christian Dior, which became the first of many acquisitions of his luxury good empire. Over the years, LVMH has acquired huge cornerstone brands such as Louis Vuitton, Givenchy, and Sephora. Now LVMH has nearly $53 billion in sales from 70 brands and 4,590 retail stores. All that hard work has paid off, clearly, for the $100 billion leader. Employees at Wayfair, the fast-growing online seller of home furnishings, founded by a pair of Boston billionaires, staged a walkout on Wednesday as a protest over the company selling bedroom furniture to immigrant detention centers. The company sold $200,000 worth of products to BCFS, a government contractor that lists U.S. Border Patrol as one of its partners. The protesters alleged that the company made $86,000 in profit off the contract and request that all profits be donated to RACES, a Texas nonprofit that handles immigration issues. 547 Wayfair employees sent a petition circulated internally asking billionaire chief executive Niraj Shah to cease business with all border camp contractors, but Shah allegedly refused. Wayfair co-founder Steve Conine said the company has a duty not to be a discriminatory business and is not a political entity in light of the walkout. Speaking of immigration policy clashes, the topic was a major one in the first Democratic primary debate of the 2020 presidential race. On night one, Julian Castro, the former housing secretary under Barack Obama, led the pack when it came to pro-immigrant policies. He even sparred with Beto O'Rourke over whether crossing the border should be illegal. O'Rourke, Castro, and Cory Booker all spoke Spanish on stage in an attempt to connect with Latino voters. The immigration debate has continued to get louder this week after the New York Times published a photo of a father and his 23-month-old daughter who drowned in the Rio Grande while attempting to cross the border. On top of that, third-party observers have said that migrant children, who are separated from their families and held at U.S. facilities, are often detained in centers that lack basic hygiene, such as soap and toothpaste. Thanks for tuning in to Forbes Flash this week. We'll see you next week.